A gruesome rape and murder is sparking new outrage in India, and protesters are demanding swift and deadly justice. CNN's Scott McLean has more.
In a country where some 100 sexual assaults are reported every single day, one case has struck a nerve. Last Wednesday, in the central Indian city of Hyderabad, police say four men dragged a stranded woman to a hidden area near a road where they raped and strangled her. Police say the men, who've confessed, conspired to attack her. One of the men had deliberately let the air out of her scooter tire. Later, they dumped her body under a highway overpass and set it on fire. As word of the crime spread, so did the protests.
Things were not getting better at all, but this case has triggered the outrage that you are seeing today.
Days later, there was another horrific case in a northern Indian village. A drunk man allegedly lured a six-year-old girl out of her school with candy, then raped and strangled her. Suspects in both cases have been arrested, but that hasn't dulled the public outrage.
Every girl is suffering from this. Every girl scares to go after night. Every girl is like scared to go out.
The crimes have caught the attention of the Indian Parliament. One member said rapists need to be brought out in public and lynched. Another lawmaker suggested offenders should be castrated. India has had this debate before. In 2012, a woman was gang raped on a bus in New Delhi and died from her injuries 2 weeks later. The case set off national protests and prompted stricter penalties for rape. Then, last year, after an 8-year-old girl was raped and murdered, the law was changed again to allow the death penalty in cases where the victim is under 12.
If women chop off the heads of a few of these rapists, then automatically we'll see the society change for the better.
But no matter the punishment, with tens of thousands of rape cases piling up in Indian courts, justice won't come easily or quickly. Scott McLean, CNN, London.
My next guest is leading a hunger strike protest in response to these brutal crimes. Swati Maliwal is the chairwoman of the Delhi Commission for Women and joins me now from Delhi. Thank you so much for talking with us. So the details of these crimes are horrifying, and we have seen time and again the suspects arrested but justice never served. What all are you hoping to achieve by holding this hunger strike? You've just started it and you intend to hold it indefinitely, but what can be achieved here?
I'm going to sit on an indefinite hunger strike because I've had enough. In 3 years, Delhi Commission for Women, which is a statutory body, we've handled over 55,000 cases of brutality against women in Delhi alone. In Hyderabad, what has happened, the way the girl was gang raped and the way she was burnt alive. In Rajasthan, a six-year-old girl, in the manner in which she was raped in her school dress and strangulated, her eyes popped out. Whether it is the case of an eight-month-old baby who was raped, or whether it is all these cases, or whether it is the continuing news of all cases coming from all across the country, I think we all have had enough. The country lacks stringent mechanism to punish the rapists. Last year also, I had sat on an indefinite hunger strike. On the 10th day of my hunger strike, the center created a law in the country which said that from now onwards, at least rapists of children will be given very stringent punishment in 6 months. But even that law is yet to be implemented. There is a lack of police resources, lack of police accountability, lack of fast-track courts, and that is my demand, that a stringent mechanism which includes strengthening of all these aspects need to be set up immediately. That's the need of the hour. It is very shameful for my country that today the chief of a statutory body is having to go on a hunger strike because I'm left with no other option. The government only hears this way. They are not hearing my letters. They are not heeding to my various notices and action that we have done. So this is the only way that is left, and I'm going to resort to it.
Now, some politicians are calling for the lynching and castration of these rapists and murderers. What should be their penalty, and why is the justice system in India so slow to respond to these crimes?
Yes, the parliament is debating right now, and the parliamentarians, some of them are saying lynch them, some of them are saying whatever. But the idea is that you are the parliamentarians of the country. You are not there to express your anger and anguish. You are there to take action. You are there to force the central government to make very concrete and lasting changes. Delhi police right now is lacking 66,000 police personnel for the past 13 years. I think that is the need of the hour. Each and every police officer is handling 600 cases. How do you expect them to serve justice? Similarly, Delhi is lacking 45 fast-track courts. And the entire country, there's so many districts in the country which are not even having a single fast-track court. No police accountability is set. For the past 13 years, the center is trying to create a software to digitize the functioning of the police across the country, and that software is yet to be created. I'm a software engineer. It doesn't take rocket science to do that. So we are not talking about these parliamentarians. They're not talking about concrete issues. They're not trying to set up systems in this country. And it's really sad that all that they're doing is talking. I think I appeal to the parliamentarians, if you are not able to do anything within the parliament, please come out on the street. Please sit with me. Please go on an indefinite hunger strike. And let's get these systems created.
And explain something to me. What is it that's created this rape culture in India that men seem to think that they can do this to women?
People are not scared. People feel they can get away with anything. There are so many times that rapes have happened, and these rapes have happened by people who were out, who were already convicted of rape, or who were already involved in a rape case and were out on bail. So how do you ensure systems till the time? How do you ensure deterrence till the time there are no systems? So I think that whenever you speak to a parliamentarian, or whenever you're speaking to a leader, people talk about the mentality of the people. I think that mentality of Indians by and large is pretty good. I'm sitting on this hunger strike. I sat on a hunger strike before also. There were thousands and lakhs of men and women who came to me and who said that they feel for this country. They don't want this rape culture. By and large, we are a God-fearing country. We believe in respecting women. But it's very unfortunate that few criminals are out in the open, and the governments fail to nab them, to punish them, and to create stringent systems to in order to ensure that there is deterrence in the country against rape.
We hope that your protest, your hunger strike, ends in justice being served here. Many thanks to you, Swati Maliwal, for joining us. We appreciate it.